welcome back to my channel. So I will talk about the supplies you need, I will talk about how to feed them, what they eat, and just, I mean, mainly the most important things that they require in order to live a happy lifestyle. Quick disclaimer, guys, I am not a professional, I am not a veterinarian. I just know based on my experiences and my research, my hard research. With all that being said, please keep on watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like down below. Give a comment if you have a question about these animals, if you have a question about their care or something I didn't mention in this video, that would be awesome. Thank you so much. Let's just get in the video. So here's Neptune, here's 1 year old, and as you can see, his chin is red. They do change in color, not as a chameleon. Every basilisk lizard can depend. They all have different personalities, and I guess that's why I love them so much, and I have two for that reason. I mean, he's just relaxed here. As long as they feel comfortable, I think they'll be fine. They eat variety of insects. They could eat fish, they could eat frogs, other lizards, snakes. I've heard they eat literally anything. As far as extra care, I would say I recommend cutting their nails. Here you guys can see what I use to cut their nails. Their nails are really small, but if you're really delicate, it'll do the work. Here I have a green basilisk. This is a female. Her name's Trixie, as I said before. She is, I would say, half a year. I can't remember when I bought her. They told me and I forgot. She is so much bigger than Neptune, as you can see here. And as far as how big they grow, I will say that she'll probably grow twice her size still, but it's mainly more on the tail. Their tail is usually what grows more and more. Their body length grows a little bit, but nothing crazy, nothing like you need to change size tank every year, and nothing like that. If you decided just give him crickets, I would definitely recommend you get these Fluckers High Calcium Cricket Diet, and it makes sure that they're full of calcium. That way your animal, pet, whatever reptile you have will definitely get these benefits from calcium, because they do need it. It's really important for their diet. If you decide to use worms, let's say super worms, giant worms, whatever worms, obviously depending on the size of the animal, I will recommend this product called the Reptile Calcium. This is the one with the D3. You could do with D3 or without. So here is my tank here in the corner of my living room. Like I said, this is an 18 by 18 by 32. It is perfect size. So up here outside the tank, I have this combo dome from Zoomed. One side is UV light and one side is heat light or heat lamp. You can see I only have the UV light here on because it is warm today here in Los Angeles and they don't need extra heat. It is pretty warm. As long as they have high humidity, that is more important than heat. I decided to break it apart just because I thought it looked just more realistic and real and different. I don't know. That's just personal preference, really. I have these wooden chunk pieces here. Ignore the poop right there. Ew. I have these right here. There are two of them together. And there's Terrarium moss in between just to make it more of a realistic view. But as you can see, I have this life plant here. I honestly don't know the name. This is a beautiful plant. Quick story, you can skip for like 10 seconds, but when I had this plant, at first it was so beautiful. It was like 6-8 like big leaves. It was just gorgeous. But when I got her, she ruined it. I don't know if you can see here, she just chunked it all off. It's just pretty crazy. And if you see in detail, you can see all the cuts that she made. It is in a wooden chunk piece in here, which is pretty cool. I got this from Reptile Factory. Thank you. And I have this, I don't know what you would say. It's just a skull from Mexico. I have a lot of Terrarium moss just because I feel like it gives it a more of a cool vibe. And it, under this, there's a lot of dirt. I don't even want to touch it. But under this, there's a lot of dirt. So I feel like this helps it just stay in place. Since they run around a lot, they move a lot of stuff. So, and right here, as you can see, I have the worms right here, and they are covered with the calcium powder. As I said, they love climbing, but when they are hungry or thirsty or hot, they definitely go down here and do either or. I honestly don't know the name of this thing, but I'll make sure I'll link it down below if you guys want this for sure. I love this thing. It just looks so cool. Oh my goodness. I love that. If you want to include like a water area like this, you don't have to do that. You could just as simply use a water bowl and just set it up in the corner somewhere. That's perfectly fine as long as... I have two basilisk lizards, one green and one blue. Blue? So don't do that, please. She's just trying to say hi. Hi. Don't jump on it. No. Oh.